Draymond Green. Now, this is Shaquille O'Neal. This is Kenny the Jet Smith. Charles Barkley here on this side. But I think you know all the guys here on this set.
You know his nickname, Ernie?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
What is it?
You tell me.
Day-Day.
Day-Day.
Why is it Day-Day?
Because mama called him.
Oh, Day-Day. That's right. Yeah, I did hear that before.
So honestly, give me your level of concern with the start you guys had, the fact you fell down by 17 in an elimination game. Is concern the right word, or was there doubt?
I don't think there was ever doubt, but you have to be concerned when you're in an elimination game and you go down 17 points at home in the first quarter because the effort wasn't there. You know, we gave up a ton of open shots and we weren't moving on offense. Everybody was just standing there. So that's the level of concern, but I never had any doubt that we can overcome that if we locked in.
You know, everybody in America wanted this, in the Western Conference Finals. Honestly, did you think it would be coming to a deciding Game 7?
I didn't. I thought, you know, we could have got this done earlier. I think in Game 4, we kind of gave a game away. And in Game 5, I think we gave a game away. But nonetheless, we know how good of a ball club they are. We knew that it wasn't going to be easy. So never want to go to Game 7. But when you're down 3-2, you definitely want to go.
Well, I just can't simply ignore this. I've been able to put Charles back with Michael Jordan.
Or were you?
Yeah, I was the one who did that. And this is Draymond Green, let me finish what I'm saying. Who is a key member of this championship mix, who does multiple things, and actually at times is very annoying to the opponent. Very similar, and this is what I'm going to say, Charles, very similar to what you were for opponents when you played against. So I think a lot of the things that rub you wrong against him, you actually are the architect of them.
And I agree with
you.
That.
Are the architect of them.
You did all the stuff.
You are the architect.
You did all the stuff you did.
You guys are trying to make a mountain out of molehill.
No, I made
a sarcastic statement about Draymond at halftime of one of our games, and everybody tried to take it to a whole nother level.
Okay.
He know I think he's a hell of a player. I've told him that. I've never said anything bad about him.
You guys are trying to make anything of it. I'm just letting you know that the things that annoy you, you created him.
What?
The things that annoy you about him,
no,
you
I,
did.
I have people who have said to me, like, when you and Draymond see each other, I said, dude, number one, we bump each other a few times, but we say hello and then we move on. This notion.
Okay, then what annoys you, Ben? You said the other day.
Well, you asked Kevin Durant the other night.
What annoys you?
Is Draymond as annoying?
And Draymond, you get the answer.
Yeah.
When he says what annoys you, you could say if he actually did those things when he played.
Absolutely.
No. Okay. Okay. What annoys you?
Number one. He's never committed a foul.
No. You won't make me curse on national TV. Yes, you did.
What else?
That pretty much it.
What about his physicality?
When he what now?
When he pushes and shoves guys out the way.
He knows what he's doing, too.
He's
trying to physically impose his will. I have no problem with the way he plays. I just said sometimes when he starts yelling and screaming or he doesn't admit he committed a foul, it drives me nuts.
Okay.
Right. And I've said he would be a perfect guy to play with, but he would be annoying to play against.
Okay. Well, how do you take
it? Let's let the man, the guest, speak.
Okay.
To be honest with you, I don't think any of us in the NBA has committed a foul. no one likes when the referees call a foul on them, but I can't get bad with that at times. And my mom always reminds me of it. My grandmother would say it. My uncle was really hard on me about it. So, you know, I could understand that. Nonetheless, as much respect for my way.
Thank you. Let me ask you a question. Did y'all make a conscious effort? This is just basketball related. Number one, I think you do a hell of a job. I apologize for saying I want to hit you. I was wrong for saying that. Okay,
I'm Michael Jordan, and now I got them together.
So
I'm gonna get you and Tiger back too.
Listen, Dr. Phil, did y'all talk about? I mean, maybe I'm talking about y'all's strategy, but did y'all make a conscious effort to play more guys to try to start wearing this team down?
Not necessarily. When Andre went out, you know, we got to find better rotations. You know, Andre is a key part and, you know, a key piece in everything that we do on the offensive end and the defensive end. Mm-hmm. And with him going down, you just got to try to find a different a bunch of different rotations. Looney's not used to playing 30 minutes a game. Mm-hmm. Jordan Bell isn't used to playing those amount of minutes. And so you got to kind of stagger those guys and try to keep them where they're comfortable and, you know, where their level of conditioning is. And so that's when the more guys started to come into play is when Andre went down.
Did Steve have a mention to y'all guys they only playing seven people?
I mean, we notice it. You know, when Bob Mute went out the lineup, he stopped playing. I think they were bringing Gerald or Eric Gordon off the bench, mm-hmm. and that was pretty much it. So we kind of noticed it, and we know that, you know, James has to do a lot for them and Eric Gordon has to do a lot for them. So you just want to try to make them work for the stuff as opposed to the first quarter where we gave them everything.
Everyone knows you're the vocal leader on the team. My question to you is when you're talking to different guys, because me and you were similar, so my question is when you're talking to different guys, do you have to change your tone and your pattern, like when you're talking to guys that are a little bit more sensitive?
Absolutely. I think, you know, a part of being a leader is understanding your guys, understanding who you're leading. You can't lead everybody the same way. Now, there's a time and a place where everybody's just going to get it however you're going
to get it. Who gives it to you if you're giving it to those guys?
KD.
Okay.
KD will come at me a lot. Steph will tell me to lock in. He don't really yell, but KD really goes at me a lot.
Okay, so let's look at Monday night. On the road for a game seven. Against a team where right now we don't know if Chris Paul is available or not, but with a hamstring injury, certainly not 100%. How is this team, that team, different without Chris Paul in it, and how do you prepare for them without Chris Paul?
We have to prepare like Chris Paul is going to play. Every time we face these guys, you just got to think he's going to play. But Chris is their floor general. I think he's the general of the team. James Harden is definitely the best player, but Chris, I think, is, you know, the head of the snake. And so we have to prepare like he's going to play, but they are different without him. And we understand that, but that can be our focus going into the game. They have enough guys who's more than capable, and we got to be try to stop those guys as well.
Last one.
What's really interesting about this series, you guys have only played well maybe a game and a half out of the six games. What is that?
Honestly, we feel the same way. You know, we just feel like we haven't really put 48 minutes together yet. And you got to give them some credit. Their defense has been great. Mm-hmm. And they've been really playing well offensively. So what better game to put that game together than game seven? So that'll be our focus going into it. But you got to give them a lot of credit for what we've struggled with throughout this series.
Before we let you go, apparently the guys in the truck have dug up piece of video you might want to watch.
Oh my goodness.
This is Charles being put to the floor by Sean Bradley.
Looks like he got shot.
Watch, come on, man. Watch this right here.
Bro,
this is
on,
this is where he
come
goes
on,
down
man.
For
he's
the
such
count.
An actor.
This is where
look at him. Look at him. He's such an actor. My hip. Come
right
on.
Oh.
Come
look,
on. Keith Jones is still
here. It comes
look,
right
look
here.
Look, watch. Stop it, man.
My hip and my back.
Stop it.
Hey, man,
it took
I got
four
hurt
security
for
guards
real.
To pat you off.
I got hurt.
Sean
I got
Bradley.
Hurt for real on that play, man.
Man up.
I got
Sean Bradley's like 122 pounds.
Man up.
The Twitter machine.
Uh-oh.
The
this
Twitter machine is working overtime. I have a feeling that's not the only one.
I love it.
You're right.
That's what we're going to be on the post game.
Yeah. Oh, this is good.
No need for anybody to be nervous. It went swimmingly. Draymond Green, thanks a lot for coming up, man.
Thank you.
See you Monday in Houston, man.